This little girl has been missing for 2 years and nobody thought to report her missing. In December of 2021, police in the city of Manchester, New Hampshire received a missing persons complaint by the Division of Children, Youth, and Families regarding a 7-year-old girl by the name of Harmony Montgomery. According to an affidavit, Manchester police initially received a call from Harmony's mother, Crystal Sorey, regarding her whereabouts on November 18, 2021. The police contacted DCYF to obtain previous addresses for Harmony's father, Adam Montgomery, but none of those leads panned out, and both father and daughter were unable to be located. The most bizarre part? Harmony was last seen in October of 2019, when she was just 5 years old. That is correct. It has taken 2 years for Harmony to be reported missing.
So according to her last sighting in 2019, Harmony is around 4 feet tall and weighs 50 pounds. She has blue eyes, naturally blonde hair, and happens to be blind in her right eye. She also wears glasses to aid her vision. In 2019, she was enrolled in school in Massachusetts, but later stopped attending. So why did she stop attending? Was it COVID-related? I mean, that's quite possible.
Unfortunately, we weren't able to get a solid reason as to why she stopped attending school. So on December 31st, 2021, detectives spoke with Adam's wife, Kayla Montgomery, who shares 3 younger children with Adam. She stated the last time she had physically seen Harmony was sometime in November or December of 2019, after Adam advised her that he was dropping his daughter off with her mother in Lowell, Massachusetts. She also advised that she had seen Harmony with a black eye in the past, which Adam dismissed as the result of children playing rough.
Kayla had not seen Adam since October of 2021 and had not heard from him since November. She stated that Adam was living in a sober living house and had left to live with another woman in Maine. The same day, police were finally able to make contact with Adam, who was found sleeping in a vehicle in the area of Harville Street in Manchester with his new girlfriend, Kelsey Small, whom he'd been having an affair with for over a year. Kelsey claimed that she had never seen any of Adam's children from his previous relationships and said that she had no information regarding Harmony's whereabouts. In fact, Adam had never spoken about Harmony at all.
Police became concerned during their interview with Adam as his story became inconsistent and he eventually refused to answer questions. Adam claimed that he had dropped Harmony off with her mother around Thanksgiving of 2019. At that time, Crystal was living in Lowell, Massachusetts with her then-boyfriend Joseph Eckert. However, Joseph was also interviewed that same day and claimed that he had never met Harmony ever in his life.
Harmony's mother, Crystal, recently posted a series of photos of the young girl, imploring people to come forward with any information regarding her. And this is a quote from her Facebook, quote, "Listen, please, if anyone from the Manchester, New Hampshire area or even Mass has seen my 7-year-old daughter Harmony or her father Adam Montgomery, please reach out to me ASAP. She is currently missing. There will be a press release this evening giving more information about the situation and who to contact. Please share this," end quote.
In a later post, she added, quote, "Please, I'm begging you, if anyone has seen my daughter or knows anything, please contact the detectives at the bottom of this article or contact me directly. Harmony, mommy's coming for you, I promise, and I will never let you go. Hang on, baby," end quote.
Crystal also lashed out at folks who slammed her for failing to report her missing child in the past 2 years. In a Facebook post, she stated, quote, "My daughter is missing and this is what people are focusing on? Throwing my past on Front Street and trying to make it look like I don't care?" End quote. Eventually, Crystal set her profile to private.
It had been speculated that Crystal Sorey had been a habitual drug user who had been in and out of rehab multiple times. Additionally, reports claim that Adam Montgomery is also an addict, thus why he was allegedly living in a sober living house. The last time Crystal had physically seen her daughter was during an Easter 2019 FaceTime call.
So this case, for me, echoes the Ayla Reynolds case in so many ways. So we have a mother, Crystal, who, much like Trista, did not have custody of her daughter because she was going to get herself cleaned up. And in the interim, while the father has custody of the child, she turns up missing. And it really bums me out because I know when this was going on, I mean, it's still going on with Ayla. She hasn't been found. But in the very beginning, a lot of people threw a lot of shade on Trista For one, being an addict, two, not having custody of her daughter. Well, you know, I really feel that folks who are addicted, who clean themselves up and make every attempt, should have their children. And Trista was doing just that, has done that, and looks like Crystal was doing the same for herself. So I really, really resent the fact that folks are giving her crap for this.
If truly she had to give up custody in order to get clean so she could be a better mother for her daughter, it's hard for me to hold that against her. I know when you hear, oh, Harmony hasn't been reported missing and it's been 2 years, you immediately think, okay, well, where were the parents? But it's hard to put that blame on Crystal for me personally, given that she was trying to clean herself up.
There are some reports that actually state that when Crystal was in Lowell, she would go try to find them. That she had made other reports before and they weren't taken seriously. That before the November report, other reports were made and she was trying to find Adam and Harmony.
Hi, baby. If you can see me, if you can hear me. I want you to know that I never stop looking for you and I won't stop fighting until I find you, okay? And you stay strong and mommy's right here fighting for you. I love you.
And on top of that, if you think about it for a little bit, why other family members hadn't reported missing for 2 years or in the pandemic. A lot of folks haven't seen their family. I can say that I've seen my family maybe a handful of times in the last 2 years.
I didn't even get to see my baby niece for many, many months during the pandemic. So this isn't an uncommon thing. We both know many people that have not seen family members for a very long time.
So as I had stated before, some have wondered why it took so long for Crystal to report her daughter missing. And according to a now deleted Facebook post, Crystal stated, quote, "Myself and her family have filed dozens of reports of abuse and neglect, and nothing was done until I called police and wrote a letter to the New Hampshire mayor. This is all I will say until I'm allowed to say more. I will not hinder my daughter's investigation," end quote.
And I'm sure if all those things were done, it will all come out in the end. Yeah. It doesn't surprise me that she's not allowed to talk or provide proof of that. At first, when I heard this, I felt like the mother didn't do enough. I would wait to pass judgment on that because it very well could have been that she was trying to do everything right and was being blocked or was not taken seriously. Recently, police searched a home in Manchester for several hours with trucks and tarps as part of the investigation into Harmony's disappearance. Investigators blocked off a property on Guildford Street, but would not comment on what they were looking for or what, if anything, they found.
News sources spoke with the woman who lives at that home. She said that she had just moved there and had never met or had anything to do with Harmony or her family. She and her neighbors stated that they have no idea what, if anything, was found. They also said they don't know much about the family. News sources have also spoken to residents at an old address registered to Harmony's father. The anonymous resident who lives there used to be neighbors with Harmony's dad and came to his defense.
Quote, "Shocking and sad, especially when you know the person involved. It's just crazy. I know everybody wants to point to him like he hurt her or something, but he's not capable of doing that. He is such a good guy. I saw him here with his other kids. He used to talk to us about his daughter a few times. You could tell he was really sincere about it. He told us that the mother came to the grandmother's house they lived at and took her and never brought her back," end quote.
In a Facebook post, a young woman named Naya discussed Harmony's father. Quote, "Hello everyone, I'm Harmony Montgomery's older cousin. As many of you know, a report for my cousin was made stating she'd been missing for 2 years. Yes, that is accurate, but what many of you don't know is Harmony is in or was last known to be in the custody of her father, Adam Montgomery, last known in the area of Manchester. Any information would be highly appreciated, even if it's years old. Please don't be shy to direct message me or call. Any information helps. This post is also for the ignorant people who want to form an opinion off a news broadcast that doesn't give you any valid information," end quote. We actually reached out to Naya for a comment, like she suggested, but as of the date of this recording, she hasn't responded.
Additionally, Harmony's uncle, Michael Montgomery, made the following Facebook post, quote, "Everyone, whether I know you or do not, even if we have never spoken, if you are seeing this, please do me a massive favor and share this post. This is my niece, Harmony. She is missing. I do not know why it says missing since 2019. That info is wrong. But nonetheless, the more eyes that see this, the better. Someone has to have info on her whereabouts, and you never know if a friend of a friend of a friend can lead the police to some information on her," end quote.
In a comment, he wrote, quote, "Her father has had the whole family blocked by phone and social media for years. He had custody of Harmony last I spoke with him in 2019. The mother has recently been trying to get visits with her but could not get a hold of the father. The MPD, I'm assuming Manchester Police Department, has gotten a hold of him and he is not cooperating. That's all I know. I live 1,500 miles away, end quote.
Washington, D.C. television anchor Blair Miller revealed that Harmony is the sister of his adopted son, Jameson. Miller shares three adopted sons with his husband, Jonathan. He stated that, quote, when we adopted Jameson, he'd been well aware of his relationship with Harmony, end quote. He said it was difficult to keep that relationship going over the years. He said that he had never met Harmony, but he said they have had a close relationship with Jameson's and Harmony's mom. He shared that Jameson often asks about his sister and that his family has unsuccessfully tried to reach Harmony since adopting Jameson in November of 2019.
Miller also tweeted the following, quote, we've been asked this question repeatedly and understandably. Why did we not adopt Harmony and Jameson together? When we adopted Jameson, Harmony had already been reunited with family. Jameson had not, so we were able to adopt just him. Harmony's case was closed. Please bring awareness to her case. It's devastating, end quote.
Now, finally, on January 4th, 2022, Adam Montgomery was arrested and booked on an array of charges, including felony second-degree assault in connection with 2019 conduct against his daughter. Prosecutors have also charged Montgomery with one misdemeanor charge of interference with custody and two misdemeanor charges of endangering the welfare of a child pertaining to Harmony. Additionally, Adam's wife Kayla was arrested on January 5th, the following day, for welfare benefits fraud after failing to remove Harmony from her family's social services account. It's alleged that Kayla illegally collected over $1,500 in food stamps.
Authorities initially did not go into detail about what 2019 conduct prompted the charges, and it was also not clear if the charges were directly pertaining to the disappearance of Harmony. However, according to an affidavit, Adam was arrested on probable cause of second-degree assault stemming from an incident that occurred between July 1st and July 22nd, 2019, where Adam knowingly caused bodily injury to Harmony by striking her face. Now, this is not the first time I've heard this. Also in the affidavit, which they actually had parts of it blacked out, but I found it through a different source, her uncle Kevin, I believe his name was, he came forward and said one time he went over there and Harmony looked like she had been beaten by like a man and like guys look like when they're in an MMA fight or a boxing match, like her eyes were all swollen. And he also stated that Adam admittedly said that he went and bashed her around the house because she was supposed to be watching her infant brother and he started to cry and she put her hand over his mouth. So that was the reason he beat her up.
Now, whether this was reported early or not, I'm not sure. I did watch a press conference with the Manchester Police Department, and I believe a reporter asked that, and the police declined to comment.
Why was he not arrested then?
That's the thing I wonder. Was this actually reported in time? Are they going off witness statement without any evidence because they believe Adam is the person of interest in Harmony's disappearance and they want to hold him?
That's my guess.
Because we've looked at other cases in the past where there's been a lot more evidence on people and they've just let them go. It seems like they don't have a lot of evidence to hold Adam, but the Manchester police have not been transparent with their evidence, and understandably so, as this is an active investigation. They want to find Harmony.
It really seems like they're being real bulldogs over this. And are digging deep.
I mean, I
commend it.
I mean, I'll say at the press conference, I don't recall his name, but he was definitely talking the talk. He was saying all the right things. And if the Manchester police follows up like they say they're going to, it makes me hopeful they're going to find Harmony and do what it takes to find her.
Additionally, police have stated that Harmony, then 5 years old, was last seen at a Manchester home after officers answered a service call in 2019. Anyone with relevant information on Harmony Montgomery has been urged to contact the Manchester Police at 603-668-8711 or Detective Jack Dunleavy, that might be the guy you saw, at 603-792-5561. One can also anonymously call the Manchester Crime Line at area code 603-624-4044. 4-0. We're going to have all of that information in the show notes. We also have it in a community post currently.
The reward for information regarding Harmony's whereabouts has just recently been increased to $94,000. So there is no reason to not come forward with this.
Yeah, a lot of really good people went and put money up. I believe the U.S. Marshal Service, a couple area businessmen in New Hampshire, and even a businessman as far out as Nevada put the money up for this.
This definitely hit close to home, as we've done a few cases in our home state of Maine regarding child abuse and missing children. And to see this happen in New Hampshire, not even 2 hours from us, it was definitely important for us to cover this. And furthermore, I am happy to see so far that the police are doing what it takes to find Harmony, because I'll tell you, in the past, and I won't go too much into detail, you know, if you've been listening to us for a while, the Maine State Police could use some improvements in the ways they use to find missing people and children.
Like I said, with the Ayla Reynolds case, it's been years now. It has been like over a decade. And I feel they have enough information to arrest and hold Justin DiPietro, her father. There's enough information that they could get him on something.
In our opinion.
And they've yet to do that.
But the best thing you can do for Harmony's case, share this video, share the information down below, especially with people that you know are in the New Hampshire area, especially in the Manchester area. As far as the best thing you can do for us, you can listen to this episode to the end, as that helps our retention rate on YouTube. You can share this video with someone that you think would like it. Hitting like and subscribe, it goes a long way to helping us grow our channel so we can better use our platform raising awareness in cases like these. We also have a very wonderful group of people that are going the extra step to support us on Patreon. I will put their names up right now. I also want to say welcome to our new patron, Tracy.
Welcome, Tracy.
And also, thank you to Levi, Cammy, Chaka, and Holly, our highest tier Patreon supporters. There's their lovely pictures right now. Holly, in specific, has her own business called Halls and Dolls. She makes high-quality face masks. They are very wonderful. There's some pictures of them right now. We have our Etsy link down below.
And we have many of them.
We have very many of them. If you're in the market for face masks, I highly recommend checking out Holly's page.
I will say that they are the only mask that doesn't make my glasses cloud right up.
And the only mask that doesn't chafe my face and make it break out. Also, special shout out to Melissa, who made another generous contribution to our PayPal. Melissa, we'd like to include you in the Levi tier. Please get a hold of us, miserymachinepodcast@gmail.com, if you want your picture showcased or anything like that. We very much appreciate you making contributions directly to us on our PayPal account, as it does cut out the middleman in question, that is Patreon. Now, if you too want to support us on Patreon, patreon.com/themiserymachine, you get access to all of our secret episodes, you get access to our secret Discord Snapchat groups, and you may even get a postcard.
Haunted one.
patreon.com/themiserymachine. And if you want to donate to our PayPal, paypal.me/themiserymachine. But until next week.
We love you.
We love you.
Bye. Bye.